and now our lips. O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning,
the Lord.
The Lord be praised.
reading from the second letter to Timothy. Remind them of this, and warn them before God that they are to avoid wrangling over words, which does no good, but only ruins those who are listening. Do your best to present yourself to God as one approved by Him, a worker who has no need to be ashamed, rightly explaining the word of truth. Avoid profane chatter, for it will lead people into more and more impiety, and their talk will spread like gangrene. Among them are Hymenaeus and Philetus, who have swerved from the truth by claiming that the resurrection has already taken place. They are upsetting the faith of some. But God's firm foundation stands, bearing this inscription: The Lord knows those who are His, and let everyone who calls on the name of the Lord turn away from wickedness. In a large house, there are utensils, not only of gold and silver, but also of wood and clay, some for special use, some for ordinary. All who cleanse themselves of the things I have mentioned will become special utensils, dedicated and useful to the owner of the house, ready for every good work. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. A reading from the Gospel according to Mark. People were bringing little children to him in order that he might touch them, and the disciples spoke sternly to them. But when Jesus saw this, he was indignant and said to them, "Let the little children come to me. Do not stop them, for it is to such as these that the kingdom of God belongs. Truly I tell you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will never enter it." And he took them up in his arms, laid his hands on them, and blessed them. As he was setting out on a journey, a man ran up and knelt before him and asked him, "Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" Jesus said to him, "Why do you call me good? No one is good but God alone. You know the commandments. You shall not murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness. You shall not defraud. Honor your father and mother." He said to him, "Teacher, I have kept all these things in my youth." Jesus, looking at him, loved him and said, "You lack one thing. Go and sell what you own and give the money to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come, follow me." When he heard this, he was shocked and went away grieving, for he had many possessions. The word of the Lord.
I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son,
Let us pray. Show thy mercy upon us. O Lord, save the state. And do thy ministers with righteousness. Save thy people.
And bless thy name and house.
Give peace in our time, O Lord.
Because there is one other that fighteth for us, but only thou, O
within us.
And drink of thy Holy Spirit.
Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Be our light in the darkness, O Lord, and in your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of your only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep this night, and give your angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ, give rest to the weary, bless the dying, soothe the suffering, pity the afflicted, shield the joyous, and all for thy love's sake. It is a joy to welcome all of you to Bethesda-by-the-Sea for this service of choral Evensong in this transcendent space, listening to this gorgeous, inspiring music. So thank you all for being here tonight. I would like to invite you to a reception immediately following this liturgy, and it is in the parish hall. You can just kind of go out these doors and go that way, and you'll run into it on your right eventually. And we would love to be able to greet you personally after this service. Quick note about our music program here. Well, it's pretty remarkable, but we have a number of special music events throughout the year, and on Tuesday, we have the St. Olaf Choir visiting all the way from Minnesota, or Minnesota, I guess. But we're delighted to have them here. It is one of the premier a cappella groups in the entire country, and they will be here. I believe that there are a few tickets available left, but I would encourage you to snap them up soon. But it is a joy to welcome you here. In a few moments, we're going to be taking up a collection, and everything that we do here is only because of your generosity, and so I bid that tonight. Let us pray. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, thine unworthy servants, do give thee most humble hearty thanks for all thy goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom thou hast made. We bless thee for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for thine inestimable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we beseech thee, give us that due sense of all thy mercies, that our hearts may be unfeignedly thankful, and that we may show forth thy praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to thy service, and by walking before thee in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. Almighty God, who hast given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication unto thee, and hast promised through thy well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, thou wilt be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth, and in the world to come, life everlasting.
Thank you.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all evermore.